If you have opened this video, deep inside the heart, you really want to do well. If you have opened this video, you want to get into a better college, you want to earn more money, and you want to do well in your life. Hey guys, I'm Dr. Himanshu Gupta, and for the past 3 years, I have been guiding students to increase their productivity to help them get into better colleges like AIIMS, PGI, and MAMSI. I had secured a rank of 62 in NEET PG 2018. I had secured a rank of 10 in All India PMT 2011. And recently I completed my MD radio diagnosis from Maulana Azad Medical College. So guys, the aim of this video is that I want to share with you five principles that have helped me all throughout my student life and emerge a good student in all these exams with a good rank. So guys, let us begin with this first principle. So guys, the first principle is focus. So you must have seen many videos on how to focus better, the Pomodoro technique. So today I'm not going to discuss how you can focus for 1 hour, how you can focus for 30 minutes. But today I'm going to discuss something else which I have not seen people talking about. And guys, I call this focus as the macroscopic focus. So guys, what is this macroscopic focus? In order to do well in life, in order to be good at a skill, in order to be good during your MBBS or during your NEET UG preparation, it requires that you study consistently for a very long time. I'm not talking about long time in a day, but like for 1 year, you have to be consistent throughout the year. In MBBS, you have to be consistent throughout the 4.5 years. So guys, this is the tough part. The tough part is not studying for 8 hours. Everyone is able to do that just before the exam. But the tough part is doing that thing consistently for a very long time. So guys, this is what I call as macroscopic focus, doing that same thing for a very long time. Why are students not able to get this macroscopic focus? Why are students not able to study for a very long period of time? So guys, I have also had these phases when I was not consistent, when I was not like working hard towards my goals. And I realized during this young age, there are too many hormones working around us. We are surrounded by too many people who will try to suppress your dreams, who will try to distract you with other things, all sort of things, okay, that you are wasting time currently. So they will try to distract you with all those things. If you will think something big, they will tell you, beta, tumhara kuch nahi ho sakta. You won't be able to do that thing. And what happens with time, guys, you become an average student, you become a mediocre student, and a mediocre student is as good as a failing student. You stop thinking about your goals, you don't think that you can achieve that thing, and you know, instead of utilizing this precious time into achieving things that can change your future, you spend your time in mindless activities. Okay, so here was a reason that why you are not able to study for a long period of time. So guys, how can you get this macroscopic focus? I will tell you. Guys, you have to have that aim in your mind. You need to have that goal in your mind, and that goal should be very high. If you are dreaming to get a rank of 5000, you should dream of getting a rank 50. If you are dreaming of earning rupees 1000 per month, then you should dream of earning 1 lakh rupees per month. That should be your aim. That is how, you know, your goals, your aims will motivate you to work hard every day, to be consistent for a very long time. Okay, if you take any gold medalist in Olympics, what he or she would be thinking every day, okay, in their mind, okay, when they get up, they visualize standing there on the podium with the gold medal in their hand. You know, even during my preparation, I visualized myself going into AIIMS, okay? Though I did not go into AIIMS, but I landed up in MAMC. Because, you know, I used to visualize those things. And these things will, you know, help you to be consistent, okay? When you will not feel like studying, these things will help you to get back into studying. Now guys, coming to the second principle. The second principle is hard work. Guys, I have always believed in this thing that hard work is the key to success. You know, there are so many people nowadays talking about this smart work. Guys, this smart work is not for students. Okay, you have to work hard. Okay, because of this smart work, you know, people are trying to find shortcuts. People are trying to think, you know, I will find such books, okay, that will provide me a summary. I will find those videos that will provide me a summary. But guys, the short videos and the short notes will help you in the revision, okay? It will not help you to be in the top rank. Remember this. So you will have to work hard. There is no shortcut to success. You have to give your best. You have to study more than others. Only then you will be able to do better than others. You know, I talk to people, many students say that, you know, Marrow Question Bank, it is very hard. There are too many questions in it. But guys, you know, this is a very good thing. If questions are hard, if there are too many questions, then, you know, every student won't be able to complete that. And here is the challenge for you. Try doing that thing completely. Try doing a tough thing like Marrow Q Bank. Then you would see, you know, you will be at a better place than other students. Are you getting my point? If you do something that is tough, if you do something that is not easy, then you will land in a better place than other people that are there around you. Now guys, coming to the third principle, that is also very dear to my heart, and this third principle is sacrifices. So guys, you know, I have always kept this principle that if you have to do something well, you should be able to make sacrifices. Besides your work, everything else, okay, whether it is movies, whether it is your friends, whether it is your families, whether it is your sleep, whether it is any type of comfort, whether it is your mobile, Facebook, Instagram, okay, you will have to make all sorts of sacrifices in order to achieve your goal, in order to achieve your dreams. So guys, I would like to give you few examples during my NEET PG preparation. Guys, I was a normal person like you, and sleep was very important for me. I used to wake up at around 11 a.m. or 12 a.m. in the morning. And during my drop year, guys, my goal was very important for me. And I did not want to do this mistake. So guys, I made a promise to myself that, you know, I would just sleep in the library. Yes, for 6 months, guys, continuously I slept in the library. You know, the major advantage of doing this thing was that, you know, when I would wake up, I would wake up in front of the books. When I would sleep, okay, I would wake up on time, okay, because you cannot sleep for 12 hours in the library. That was the major advantage that I got, okay. Every day, you know, all the days, you know, I woke up at 8 a.m. and there was not even a single day. Not even a single day that I missed studying. So this is another example of hard work. You know, if someone would have asked me that you should have studied for 6 months, or you should have studied just for 8 hours or 4 hours, and you should have studied productively in that, so I won't be sitting here in front of you talking to you guys. It's only because of the hard work that I'm sitting in front of you. And guys, you know, sacrifices. So I sacrificed my bed I sacrificed my bed. Then guys, I sacrificed my friends. And you know, my friends, my good friends were so good, okay? Because once I sacrificed them, you know, I stopped talking to them, I stopped meeting them. But once I got a rank, I got all my friends back. So that, you know, that's the definition of true friend. So he will understand your situation. So you don't have to spend too much time with your friends while you are working on something very important. Are you getting my point? So I also felt like I have to meet my friends, I have to meet my family. I never went to my home, though it was just 4 hours, 4 to 5 hours from my Delhi. Okay, my home is in Chandigarh and I live in Delhi. So, but I never went there. You know, I tried to save every single day that I was getting. You know, even during the mock exams that happen during your preparation, you know, people would come up, come after their mock exams, then they would just waste the entire day. So guys, after giving any mock exam, I went straight into the library. That was the level of discipline I was having. That was the level of dedication that I was having. And if I talk about during my All India PMT days, guys, there was no television at my home. Even at that point of time, I was good that, you know, I asked my parents that there should be no cable in the home. If there would be distractions in the home, then I won't be able to study. So I was able to make sacrifices of everything in order to achieve my dream. And one more thing that I'm recalling is that, you know, during the lunch time, I would never have my lunch. Because what I realized that after having my lunch, I used to sleep for another 2 hours in the library. So I stopped having my lunch. And you know, this saved me 2 hours every day. 2 hours means 25% of the time that I was studying. Believe and reflect. Okay. So this is the final principle that I'm going to talk about. So guys, what do you mean by reflect? So guys, reflect means that, you know, at the end of the day, you just have a look at your routine, what you have done throughout your day, how much productively you have utilized your day, what are the important tasks that you have done throughout your day, what are the mistakes you have done throughout your day. So this is something reflecting grossly, okay? If you are doing a grand test, you have to reflect what are the subjects you performed really well, what are the subjects you did not do well. And you know, grand test analysis, okay, it is a part of reflection. So reflecting your grand test, guys, it will give you an insight on what subjects you need to focus more on, what subjects and topics you need to improve. You know, many students keep on asking me, sir, I have been giving marrow grand test but my score is not improving. So guys, you know, I want to tell you that you don't have to worry about improving the score. So I found the analysis in the marrow grand test very helpful. Okay, so beautifully they have given your percentile for each subject. So beautifully they have given that you are getting these many questions correct in this subject, you are getting these many questions wrong in a particular subject. So guys, if your percentile is below 50% in any subject, it is very clear you need to work upon that subject. You need to work very hard upon that subject. This is what reflection means. If you have wasted 2 hours today while watching movie or while watching a Netflix, okay, you have to reflect that I have to stop doing this thing. If you have done a mistake in the past, so I will give you another example. So guys, during my MBBS, I was not able to learn things very well. Okay, I had studied during my MBBS, but you know, I was not able to recall everything in the exam. And you know, I improved upon this mistake. So during my NEET PG, I told myself that Himanshu, you have to be a better learner this time. If you just learn the things the way you were learning during your MBBS, then you won't be able to do well. So guys, what did I do? You know, I followed the wall technique. I spent 3 hours daily to rereading things again, revising things again. Okay. And this technique, guys, helped me to remember things for a longer period of time. So this is what I want you guys to follow. If you are weak at something, if you are weak at learning, just try to reread things again and again. Okay, if you cannot reread your notes, nowadays like Perls are available. In Marrow there are Perls are available which you can reread, okay, while you are walking, while you are going for a metro. Okay, I used to utilize my time while I'm walking also, while I'm going for metro also, or any free time that I'm getting, I would open my mobile, I would just flip through something. Okay, that would help me revise things. If you are weak in doing MCQs, then start practicing a lot of MCQs. If you are weak in a concept, okay, improve upon this mistake. If you are weak upon a concept, it's because you have not read that concept very properly. It's because you have not seen the video of that concept. So try doing these things. Try working upon the mistakes, okay? In my life, guys, I've always worked upon my mistakes. Any kind of mistake. If you have done a bad thing in the past, okay, just don't do it again. Okay, you don't need to learn from anyone's experiences. You yourself have so many experiences, and if you stop doing the things that you have done wrong, okay, you would definitely excel in your life. So guys, these were a lot of principles, and I hope these principles will definitely help you. So guys, if you like the video, do give me a thumbs up, do share it with your friends, and don't forget to subscribe the channel. So all the best guys, keep working hard, bye bye.